friends, welcome back. Today we'll do a parrot painting in watercolors. Parrots are really colorful birds and painting them is really fun. I'll take you through the steps of how to paint this beautiful bird. So stay till the end so that you can try it for yourself. If we are meeting for the first time, hi, this is Modula, the artist behind Modula Creations, and I do post video tutorials like this one every single week. So stay tuned and stay connected by subscribing to my channel. Let's get started. So these are the materials that I'll be using today. I'm going to use a Dalaran Rowney travel set. This is a pan set. You could use the pan set or also you could use the tube colors. I'll be using a size 0 Raphael brush. If you don't have this brush, you could use a size 10 or a size 12 round brush. I'll be using a size 0 flat and a size 1 brush. All the materials used here are given in the description box below. Please have a look at it and you can purchase from those links. I start with the initial drawing of the parrot. The background is going to be subtle and I'm not going to concentrate on that more. For the parrot itself, I'm marking the important areas of the feathers too, as it will be easy for us when we start with the painting. I start painting the background first. It's going to be branches and trees with little bit of sky here and there. I use a light and a dark brown for the bark of the tree and greens for the leaves. I'm not going to do so much of details here in the background. And of course, as artists, we have the freedom to design our own things and you can design it as the way you want it. If you are completely new to my channel and if you are here for the first time, I am posting video tutorials, reviews, tips and trick videos like these every single week. So do subscribe and also click on the bell icon so that you get notified as soon as my videos are out. Once the background is done, I start with the parrot. For the beak of the parrot, it's going to be light brown. The first layer that I am doing is going to be very light to define the colors only. Once we have our colors defined, we can go ahead to add the details. For the top part of the head of the parrot, we will start with a light layer of yellow, orange and red. So it's going to be a combination of all these three colors. And for the feathers, we have short feather and longer feather. So you'll have to remember that each area of the feathers are going to be different in shape and size. As you see, the top part of the head is having very short feather, and as it comes down, there are longer feathers. So the upper shorter feathers are going to be in reds and oranges. I have done a similar parrot drawing in pencil. So it's completely through shading. So if you are interested in parrots and animals and in sketching, you can definitely check that too. I will link it in the card above and in the description box below. Do check that out too. So the second layer of the feathers will be in yellow and in greens. and I'll be combining these colors and mixing yellows and greens to make it very vibrant. Parrots are the most colorful birds, so there is going to be a lot of colors on these birds. That's why I love this kind of a painting, because it involves lot of colors, and as you already know, I love colors, and especially the feather area, they are going to be very colorful. They are not only colorful, these birds are among the most intelligent birds. The final longer feathers will be in blues, so I'm going to use a lighter blue first, then I will add layers on top of it. So when we paint, we have to remember to adjust the colors as we go. One main feature of the parrot is their curved and broad beak. The top beak is larger than the lower beak. Not only they are large, they are also very strong. We'll be using grays and blacks for the under part of the beak. Then we can add more details on the top part of the beak with a lighter brown. Once the beak is completely done, I slowly move on to the area around the eyes. Same way to the beak, here also we will be using light browns to show the skin there, and we will use little bit of darker brown too. In this stage, after defining this skin area, I am adding the eyes for the parrot. Eyes will be light brown and has grey and black in it at the center. Eyes are very important when you draw animals, so take your time in finishing off the eyes. Once the eyes are done completely, then we can move on to the other feather areas. So I am adding more colors now and defining each of the feathers. Remember that you need not do every feather available on the reference. You need to bring the feel of the feathers. That's very important. You have to bring out the feel that the parrot is feathery. So if you can bring that feel, that's super awesome. So continue to develop each of the feathers separately. So as I told you earlier, you need not define each of them, as you can see in the reference. It's not really required. So once you are done with building up the feathers, finally we will mark all the shadows on the feathers, beak and the skin areas. I add one more layer to the background to finish off the painting completely. One sad part to this is macaws are now in endangered list in the wild. This is mainly due to the rapid deforestation, hunting and illegal pet trade. So the next time when you see a macaw, please admire its beauty. It's so beautiful and it is the largest type of parrot available. If you like this video, do give a thumbs up to it and also share it with your friends who love painting and who love birds and animals. And do subscribe and stay connected. Thank you so much for your time for watching this video. I have linked other useful videos here, so do take a look at it too. Happy painting. Have a great week.